everybody, Kevin here, Raptor94. Welcome back to the channel, and we're back with another Fallout 4 randoms video. And this time we'll be doing Remnants and Outcast by Recluse. And if you don't know the mod's name, or you don't recognize it, he has made Fusion City Rising, and Remnants and Outcast is a sequel to Fusion City Rising. You know, you don't have to play Fusion City Rising, but it's recommended you play that mod because that mod's pretty amazing. It's a pretty large quest mod too. And this one is a sequel to Fusion City Rising. I don't know too much about its development or anything about it, so I'm going in completely blind. And this is only a beta stage too, because the mod author sent me a beta test of the mod, so I don't know what to expect, but that's the bunker you're supposed to go to. BOG Bunker. But yeah, there's supposed to be like several different factions you could join in this one, and there's like different variants of the Brotherhood, Outcasts, and tons of other I can't remember, but we'll see how it goes. But I definitely enjoyed Fusion City Rising, so I'm very, very hyped to play this mod, see what he has to offer. But we'll see how it goes. So we got two machine gun turrets here. So we got Ellen with us, so we decided to let Piper go because I have a feeling having vanilla companions might not fit well for this mod, at least for my preference, so we'll see how this goes. And as you can see, guys, I am running the game on EMB. Still have my old character set up. I also updated the West Tech Optics, the Tactical Optics mod, so I can now switch from NV. Nope, didn't want to do that. I can now switch to Night Vision, Dermo. And then we got, of course.
Let me get out my map.
And this one's supposed to be the hood where it could distribute from friendlies. But it's not working, so we'll see how it goes. I got some new weapons mod too. I do got the Mercenary mod on as well, and the P90 and the RU556, but I'm just going in blindly on this quest mod, so hopefully we'll find him as we go along. So I hope you guys are having a good week. It's definitely near the end. It's almost Friday. Pretty crazy. I will be releasing two channel update videos on Friday or Saturday as soon as possible, because I want to address some few things here and there about what's going on with YouTube and all that stuff, and also about the Mass Effect Andromeda spam. Like I say, I don't really intend on making it as spammy. Nothing about Andromeda videos, but I've been trying to get them out as fast as possible because my hard drive space is like this close of running out, so I gotta get all these videos up as soon as possible. So this whole week and next week so on will be very busy for me. And we'll see what happens. Okay, we're here, guys. We're in the BOG. Hey, Ellen. That's the guy we're supposed to talk to. And he's wearing some new armor set from the looks of it. There's some noise going on. So I am recording this at 2 a.m. So I gotta be a little bit quiet. And I am a little bit quiet. I'm a little bit tired. So I might end this video probably 3, and that's it, because I don't want to drag it on too long. I'll sell your stuff truck. Oh, that's nice. So I might talk a little bit, a little bit downer, because I am tired. Chuck Finley, you're looking smooth with that haircut there, my friend. Hello.
Hi. Hey there. Something I can help you with?
What's the story with this place?
What's the story with this place?
He's gonna say it.
Well, for starters, my name's Chuck. Chuck Finley. Part of a group of outcasts from the Brotherhood of Steel.
Outcasts.
From the D.C. area. We call ourselves the Brotherhood of Gold.
Brotherhood of Gold.
This bunker is our home in the Commonwealth.
So ask him, why do you live?
Why did you leave the Brotherhood in the first place?
It's complicated, but the short version is, the Brotherhood of Steel started out on the West Coast shortly after the Great War, and its original mission was to hoard pre-war technology. A little over 30 years ago, the Brotherhood sent a group east to explore. And, well, that group eventually settled in the DC wasteland, which is where most of the crew here grew up. Our leader was a man named Owen Lyons.
Not a Lyons.
So, in addition to acquiring technology, Lyons believed it was important to be a good neighbor and help out the local community, which eventually didn't sit well with most of the other Brotherhood. You see, we were involved in a massive project to provide clean drinking water to the DC Waste.
Yeah, I know what happened.
Well, that's a long
Andre told me the whole story.
Over time, more and more of the members of the East Coast Brotherhood chapter began to view assisting the DC community as a waste of our resources. Then Owen Lyons died. Let's just say shit got interesting after that. A few years passed and there was a power struggle. Ultimately, our choices were to follow the 16-year-old mini-Hitler who was appointed elder by the West Coast Brotherhood, or to leave for greener pastures. Most people stay. We chose to leave. That was 4 years ago. We headed northeast to the Commonwealth and been making a living here ever since.
Well, here's the thing. I don't remember them being in a bunker next to one of my Minutemen outposts, so that is a little bit concerning. This guy has came out of nowhere and built a bunker there without me knowing it, so what the heck? Am I completely blind or am I just too busy freaking helping out settlements? What are you guys doing out here?
What are you guys doing out here?
We're on a bit of a crusade.
What kind of crusade?
We're here to champion the cause of the innocent, the helpless, the powerless. You know, in a world full of criminals who operate above any law. Now listen, sorry about that. Our entertainment options here are kind of limited.
Yeah, I can see
that. We end up watching a lot of Knight Rider reruns.
Knight Riders!
But to answer your question, you could say we're like the Brotherhood of Steel, but without the whole, you know, Nazi vibe.
Yeah, I can see that.
We generally
I'm a Brotherhood center, though. I know how Adam Maxson runs his shit.
So we don't start fights with others just because their skin or DNA is a little different than ours. Except feral ghouls. Fuck those guys.
Yeah. I'm good with you there.
Yeah, most super mutants too. Bunch of bitchy little girls.
Anyway, yeah, tell me about it. Strong.
Mostly do mercenary work to pay the bills.
Strong never stops complaining.
Wild animal control, escort some travelers to and from major.
I still think
hubs,
Strong is the worst like companion in this game.
We try not to be evil, and of course we search and accumulate as much technology as we can.
So this guy is a Brotherhood of Gold. They still try to keep their old school tradition of the Brotherhood of Steel, but also helping out, you know, the powerless and taking out evil, all that type of stuff. Pretty much, these guys are old school heroes, which I kind of like that. The Brotherhood we have now, no, Elder Maxson is no. I don't like Elder Maxson, by the way, too. He wanted to kill Dance because he's a simp. I was like, no, I don't want. Spoiler alert, if you guys haven't played the game yet. But yeah. Also, I forgot to mention, special thanks to Recluse for sending me the beta link to Remnants and Outcasts. So, kudos to you, my doctor. Thank you.
You're in charge?
Me? Oh, hell no. I might be the oldest, but no one's actually really in charge.
I I'm tired, so I might be talking gibberish here, so we all hope you don't mind that, guys.
The chain of command was so inefficient it would get us all killed if we tried that bullshit here. You see, according to traditional Brotherhood rules, everything has to run through proper channels. Theoretically, if an elder is taking a dump and runs out of toilet paper,
there's a scribe
in the stall next to him. The elder isn't technically allowed to ask the scribe directly for the toilet paper. Oh no. He's got to run the request through several levels of command just to wipe his own ass. It's a goddamn ridiculous.
Oh, command, I need some toilet paper.
We're a small enough group and we don't need a formal hierarchy fucking us up. Someone has a mission, they recruit a team from within our ranks, and then they become leader for that mission. For internal disputes over stuff like who took someone so's yogurt from the fridge, well, a neutral arbitrator or jury of peers typically settles those little bullshit scenarios.
Damn. Okay. I like that little retextured metal armor too. It's pretty neat. Since the outcasts, you know, they always painted armor red. But since these guys are not really outcasts, they're now Brotherhood of Gold now. So these guys are a little bit differently than the outcasts and the Brotherhood altogether. So I'm kind of interested in what kind of other faction we could talk to and perhaps join or help out or potentially fight against.
I wanted to ask you about something else.
Okay, shoot.
Okie dokes, sign me up.
How can I get in?
Well, obviously we don't let just anyone in. The only reason you made it through the front door is our scouts spotted you a mile away and radioed in that you matched the description of the person who's been taking out raiders lately.
Okay.
So we turned off the turrets and figured we'd give you an audience.
Okay, just saw me.
We work on a you scratch my back, I'll scratch your system here. If you want in, you gotta do something for us first.
I'm game. Go ahead, I'm
listening. Go ahead, I'm listening.
The job is to retrieve a weapon for one of our brothers. As background, we do a fair amount of work transporting traders, you know, and patrons to and from Fusion City.
Yeah, I've been to Fusion City.
Goddamn,
pretty nice place.
Job providing transportation through the glowing sea.
Looks like I'm gonna go there.
Pay well. One of our crew goes by the name Grabthar. Well, he got denied entrance to Fusion City after taunting the guards there, and they confiscated his weapons.
Well,
and
he shouldn't have taunted him.
Anytech, the security division of Fusion City,
never formally
charged Grabthar with anything, but the items they confiscated ended up being sold at one of their public auctions. And one of the items they took was Grabthar's sledgehammer.
Oh, no.
That weapon has a lot of serious sentimental value to Grabthar since it was given to him by his brother Warven right before he died.
What do you need?
To the point. What do you need?
Right. So Anytech holds public auctions.
Jeez, that sounds like a little bit of an ass right
there.
That's
where they sell their confiscated property. I think the last one was over at the church in Nantic Banks.
Okay, let me adjust this mic.
Head over to Nantic Banks and see what you can find out about the auction and track down the sledgehammer. Bring the weapon back to me and we'll see about letting you in the bunker. Deal?
Come on, let me in. Yeah, let's
sure,
do it.
Sure, why not?
All right, I'll mark the location.
So it looks like I gotta go to the Glowing Sea. Find the Nitic Banks Church. I did not know where that was at. I think that's in the Glowing Sea. Pretty sure, yep. Well, actually, no. It's close, though. But I have been there before. It's not really a pleasant place. So is there any close settlement nearby? No. Okay, so it looks like we're going to have to fast travel to... Actually, we could just walk there, actually. Yeah, let's walk there. We're gonna test out this new gun. Ellen, come on, stick with me. Let's go. It's time for a new adventure. Hope you guys don't mind the stutters here and there. I don't know what's up with my computer or the game itself. I think my game is just too heavily monitored to the point that the game is just gonna poop itself one day. But I have changed the innies. I switched them back to default because the last innie chain I'm in was no good at all. So right now, if we're using the default innies, hopefully the game doesn't poop itself. All right, so we have several new weapons. We got Skibbergar's weapons redux pack, and I got right here. It's the 50 caliber 50 Beowulf. Oh boy. I haven't gotten one of this encounter in a long time. Mr. Gussie, what you at? Where's he at? I don't know which way. Okay, my sound is getting messed up because I have no idea which way. I have no idea which way is he at. Is he in this tunnel? There he is. Oh! What the? Jeez, he just instantly shot me. What the? He just instantly shoots me. He's not supposed to do that. What the hell, game? That was not right. You're not supposed to do that. Yeah, my sound's getting all messed up because I thought it was coming from the right side, and whenever I turn, looks like it's coming from the left side, and then it switches to the right side. It keeps switching back and forth. Like the sound mod I got, the reverb, ambience, overhaul mod, seriously messes up your game. Alright, so this is the way we're supposed to go. Yeah, look at that, guys. Alright. Open up. Don't mind the low-res textures over there. I know it looks terrible. Just don't look at them. Okay, yep. So, there we go. So the game is loading in. Right. Is this supposed to... happen? It doesn't look right. There's supposed to be something here, yeah. This Realin's here. Oh, oh, oh! There we go. It came to life. Alright. Yeah, see, for some reason, my game takes a lot longer to render things. Like I said, it could be hardware issue, or I just modded my game too heavily to the point it's not even playable at the point. I should just start a new game, but all the progress I made in this save, no. Definitely did not want to restart everything. At one point, I did run a grass mod too, but I have a feeling it kind of dwindled my performance by a lot, so I decided to save it. I might just save it a high resolution pack too. I don't know why I downloaded it. I just kind of want to see. I'm just was curious to see if it made any difference, but it doesn't look any difference, and performance is still the same. So I was like, why waste 70 gigs or 50, 60 gigs of hard drive space for a texture pack that doesn't make any difference? Oh, this is something different. There we go. All right, so the game was just taking its time to load everything. I'm really hoping the game doesn't crash. So, this game looks pretty good with EMB, I'm not gonna lie. Just look at this. Graphics, definitely top notch, besides that weird skybot glitch right there. If you guys don't see it. Alright, so we gotta go over there. There's a highway right there we could use. Yeah, I was wondering, I didn't see any grass. Like, wait a minute, it's supposed to be foliage, and then there was no foliage. So I was like, okay. Okay, I don't know. Oh, we got waiters. We're in the clear. See any more of you guys? Look, a grenade. Yeah, they got a little pack with some pretty good gear, that's for sure. Only saw one raider. You are blind as a bat. Oh, you didn't hear his shit. Some machine gun? No, thank you. Take that melon. See what's in this chem box. Yeah, that's what I like to see.
Nice.
Indeed. Chinese assault rifle. Long John. Didn't stand a chance. Say more guys in there, probably. Okie dokes. Yeah, this gun is pretty powerful as it is. Plus, with the perks I got, this gun is just very disgusting. Hello, any good stuff? Oh, dead guy, though. Oh! Marlix! Wow, this thing is freaking fast. Get out of here. Okay. Alright, let's move it. Yeah, I remember this is like a little settlement here. Oh, no. I think a rat scorpion could be here. Oh. Oh, shit. Woo. Clash of the Stalker. Part of Doom Base Merge Weapon Pack. Also, that mod got an update too, so it comes with the latest Glock P80 pistol and the triple barrel shotgun, which I have with me, in a matter of fact. I will definitely pull that out occasionally for close encounters. It reloads pretty decent too, so definitely gonna use that shotgun. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Alright, getting some nasty starter here, guys. Bear with me here. My computer. Like, it has a good GPU, but I don't know. Like I said, it could be just Fallout 4, because I play Battlefield 1, I play Mass Effect Andromeda, I don't get this much off of crazy stuttering lag. So I think it's just my game. Oh, there is an MP7. We'll take that. Thank you very much. Oh. Hey! Alright, let's take that. I hear another Marluk here. Yep, there he is. Whew. Hello, sir. Dude, there's 50 cows. It's very disgusting, that's for sure. Shoot slow, though, and that's the only downside. But other than that, the damage is. Whew. Disgusting. Okay, thank you very much. Let's reload. That animation though was pretty good too. Okay, so we're gonna go across here, go around it, or just swim across. I'm already pretty powerful at this, so we're just gonna swim across. Oh boy. More stutters, there we go. There he goes. So I'm definitely lagging behind on the Fallout 4 quest mods. Like I said, I've been busy playing Mass Effect Andromeda and other projects I have work on, so I'll try to get them as much as possible, but I highly doubt it. And plus, I don't want to be like a direct competitor to El Chat Speech too, so I'm just doing this video for fun, for you guys to watch, and having this 2 frame per second PowerPoint presentation. You guys got any tips to like get better? Like any tips for better performance, just leave in the comments down below, because that would be really appreciated, because this stutter is, it's disgusting. Maybe I should just turn off EMB, but the visual fidelity with EMB, I can't, it's just not the same without EMB. Oh, we got super muties. I forgot to add M's abomination mod. That way I can find some new creatures at least. This guy's a nuttin'.